My name is Chris Slyant, and I'm here to show you how XSplit can provide the easiest and most robust solutions to streaming to Facebook Live. If you wish to quickly get started, then I recommend you use XSplit Gamecaster. Go to the Accounts tab in XSplit Gamecaster and select Facebook Live from the drop-down menu in the live streaming section. Then log into your Facebook account. You might say, hey Chris, that's obvious, I click Facebook to stream to Facebook, but I don't judge. I love you all, even you. Next, go to the game you wish to stream or open the console viewer. Open the overlay and click Stream. A window will open where you can set a title and description for your scene. Oh my god, you won't believe, all in caps with three exclamation points, might be a title that works well for you, or not. Again, I won't judge you. I totally will. You're also given the option to enable continuous streaming, as Facebook Live limits streams to 4 hours in order to allow for a recorded archive to be saved to your profile. Once you have set up your stream, click on Start Broadcast to begin your live stream. You can also view and interact with your Facebook Live chat. Open the overlay, click on the Facebook icon, and enable the chat option. You can size and position your chat, along with setting the color and opacity. You can also set your chat to be visible in-game and in your stream. Finally, you can chat with your viewers in the in-game overlay. I like to call this magic, but the engineers at XSplit insist it's actually called a lot of hard work. You decide which is more fun! If you want more options for customizing your Facebook live stream, XSplit Broadcast is the way to go. To install the Facebook Live plugin, go to Outputs, then select New Output, and click on Get More Outputs. In the plugin store, click on the Facebook Live option and click Install. Click on the Authorize button and log into your Facebook account. Once you've logged into your Facebook account, you can select where you want your live stream posted. You can post it on a wall or to an event. Or you can also choose if you want to post to your page, a group page, or a fan business page. Now that you've selected where to post, you can also choose who to post as in case you're an admin for any additional Facebook pages. Finally, you can use this window for recommended bitrate settings based on your resolution. Once you've set up your Facebook Live output, click OK. To start a stream, go to the output menu and select your Facebook Live output. A window will appear where you enter the title, description, tags, and location of your live stream. Finally, you can set if your stream will be a continuous live stream. However, this will mean that a recording of your stream will not be archived on Facebook. Once your settings are done, click Start Broadcast and voila, you are now live on Facebook. And that's about all you need to know to start streaming on Facebook Live with XSplit. For more information, check out our YouTube page where you can find out all sorts of stuff about XSplit and our community. And make sure to follow us on social media where we will answer all your streaming questions. Till next time, friends.